Praise be Jesus and Mary.
Hvaljen Isus i Marija.
I like to give thanks to God for the blessing and the honor to be in this temple with all of you this evening.
Želim zahvaliti Gospodinu na časti i blagoslovu da mogu biti s vama večeras u ovome hramu.
I also like to thank Father Danto for his invitation and his support for the mission.
Želio bih isto tako zahvaliti velečasnom Anti na njegovu pozivu i na njegovoj potpori našoj misiji.
I have been invited to share with you a reflection on addictions, its roots and the way to fight them.
Pozvan sam s vama podijeliti svoje razmišljanje o ovisnostima, uzrocima tih ovisnosti i kako se boriti protiv njih.
I'm going to start with a reading from the Gospel of St. John, chapter 7, from 37 through 39.
Započet ću sa čitanjem Evanđelja po Ivanu, 7. poglavlje od 37. retka do 39.
First I will read it in English and then Josip will read it in Croatian.
Prvo ću ja pročitati na engleskom, a onda će Josip na hrvatskom.
The promise of living water. On the last and greatest day of the festival, Jesus stood up and proclaimed, "If anyone is thirsty, let him come to me, and let him who believes in me drink. For the scripture says, out of him shall flow rivers of living water." Jesus was referring to the Spirit which those who believe in him were to receive. The Spirit had not yet been given because Jesus had not yet entered into his glory.
U posljednji veliki dan blagdana Isus stade i povika: "Ako je tko žedan, neka dođe k meni. Neka pije koji vjeruje u mene. Kao što reče pismo, rijeke će žive poteći iz njegove utrobe. To reče o duhu kojeg su imali primiti oni što vjeruju u njega. Tada doista ne bijaše još došao duh, jer Isus nije bio proslavljen." Riječ Gospodnja.
It is very common for us in our society today.
Jako je uobičajeno u našem društvu danas
to hear the word addiction.
Čuti riječ ovisnost.
And we learn about many different kinds of addictions.
I čuli smo o raznim ovisnostima.
Some people have a personal experience with addictions.
Neki ovdje možda imaju osobno iskustvo s ovisnošću.
Because a member of the family has a problem like that.
Jer možda neko je u obitelji imao takav problem.
Because of someone you know.
Ili netko koga znate.
Or because you have delved into studying it.
Ili ste vi sami bili u nekoj od ovisnosti.
So our society today suffers of addictions.
Zato naše današnje društvo pati od ovisnosti.
The most common addictions are drugs and alcohol.
Najpoznatije su droga i alkohol.
And but addictions are in every area of our life.
Ali ovisnosti su u svim dijelovima naših života.
Because the roots of addiction,
jer u korijeni ovisnosti
are the voids of love.
Su nedostaci ljubavi, mjesta gdje nismo primili ljubav.
The absence of God.
Mjesta gdje nema Boga.
In a given area of our life.
U određenim dijelovima našeg života.
We can take it from a psychological way.
Možemo to promatrati iz jednog psihološkog kuta.
Or we can take it from a spiritual way.
Ili uzeti jedan duhovni pogled.
I could only share with you the spiritual side of this.
Ja s vama mogu samo podijeliti duhovni pogled.
Because I'm not a scientist.
Jer nisam znanstvenik.
So I will use the science of the cross.
I zato ću koristiti znanost križa.
As Catholics we grow up with the wisdom that God has given to us.
Kao katolici odrastamo s mudrošću koju nam je Bog dao kao dar.
Through the gospel,
po evanđelju,
through our sacred history,
po našoj svetoj povijesti,
through the great example of the testimony of the saints,
po velikim primjerima i svjedočanstvima svetaca,
through the knowledge we have of the immense powers that are invisible of God,
i po znanjima koje imamo o nadnaravnim moćima koje su nama nevidljive, a vidljive Bogu.
And then we have a vision of life that is supernatural.
I tada možemo imati pogled na život koji je nadnaravan.
We are not common people.
Mi nismo obični ljudi.
I tell people, when you see a person coming into the church,
često kažem ljudima, kada vidite čovjeka koji ulazi u crkvu,
to be baptized,
da bi bio kršten,
is a natural, rational human being.
To je prirodno, racionalno ljudsko biće.
Once is baptized,
nakon što je kršten,
is a supernatural human being.
On je nadnaravno ljudsko biće.
I give you a basic example.
Daću vam jedan osnovni primjer.
You bring water to the church to be blessed by the priest.
Donesete vodu u crkvu da bi ju svećenik blagoslovio.
That water is plain natural water.
Ta voda je obična prirodna voda.
Once is blessed by the priest,
nakon što je blagoslovljena od strane svećenika,
is no longer natural water.
Nije više obična voda.
It becomes holy water.
Postaje sveta voda.
And we know that if we spray it,
i znamo da ako ju negdje pospemo,
and there are demons around,
i demoni su u tom prostoru,
they flee.
Oni bježe.
Because every drop of that water,
jer svaka kapljica te vode,
is the Holy Spirit.
Je Duh Sveti.
And it burns them.
I spaljuje ih.
Imagine us.
Zamislite nas.
We are the favorite creatures of God.
Mi smo Božja najdraža stvorenja.
When we receive the Holy Spirit,
kada primimo Duha Svetoga,
we have a greater anointing than the water.
Imamo veće pomazanje nego ta voda.
Same spirit though.
Iako isti duh.
Different creature though.
Ali različito stvorenje.
So when we do have the knowledge of what we have received in baptism,
i kada imamo znanje onoga što smo primili u krštenju,
then we understand our supernatural life.
Onda možemo razumjeti naš nadnaravni život.
And it is very important to acknowledge that.
I jako je bitno prihvatiti to.
Because our whole life,
jer cijeli naš život,
is a meeting between our humanness, our human nature,
jer cijeli naš život je susret između naše ljudske naravi,
and the Spirit of God,
i Duha Božjeg.
And we need to work in to make it one.
I naš cilj je raditi na tome da to dvoje postane jedno.
Saint Paul says,
Sveti Pavao kaže,
that it seems as if the flesh is fighting against the spirit.
Da se čini kao da se duh bori, da se tijelo bori protiv duha.
Because the flesh tends towards sin.
Jer tijelo teži žudi za grijehom.
And the spirit towards God.
A duh za Bogom.
So our greatest challenge,
i naš najveći izazov,
is to have peace between the flesh and the spirit.
Jest pomiriti duh i tijelo.
That's what Jesus has given us.
To je ono što nam je Isus dao.
Jesus has given us the spirit.
Isus nam je dao duha
to appease our flesh.
Da bi umirio naše tijelo.
So that we can put rims on it.
Da možemo staviti jaram na njega i za konje, uzde na njega.
So we are able to educate our lower nature.
Kako bi mogli obrazovati, odgojiti našu palu narav.
And put it under obedience to the Spirit.
I staviti ju pod poslušnost duhu.
It's a science.
To je znanost.
The science of the cross.
Znanost križa.
To bring us to be Christ-centered.
Da bi nas dovelo do toga da budemo kristocentrični, usmjereni na Krista.
And God has given us everything it takes to do it.
A Bog nam je dao sve potrebno, sve što nam je potrebno da bi to učinili.
This will be called a spiritual growth.
I to se može nazvati duhovni rast.
So where do addictions come from?
Odakle onda ovisnosti dolaze?
And what are the roots?
I koji su korijeni?
Addictions come from absence of God.
Ovisnosti dolaze u nedostatku Boga.
Which makes us slaves of our instincts, senses and reason.
Što nas čini robovima našeg instinkta, osjetila i razuma.
So we will be dominated by our tendencies.
Naše želje i čežnje će dominirati nad nama.
And we live in a consumed society.
A živimo u konzumerističkom društvu.
And if we do not have a discipline,
i ako nemamo disciplinu,
our flesh,
naše tijelo,
will try to run our life.
Će pokušati voditi naš cijeli život.
Our want and desire.
Naše želje i čežnje.
Our appetites.
Naš apetit.
And if we let that happen,
i ako dopustimo da se to dogodi,
we will be slaves of the flesh.
Bit ćemo robovi tijela.
So any vice you have,
bilo koji porok koji imate,
will cover your life.
Će prekriti cijeli vaš život.
Will dominate you.
Dominirat će nad vama.
And it seems like you cannot let go of that vice.
I može se činiti kao da ne možete otpustiti taj porok.
Because you don't have a spiritual strength.
Jer nemate duhovnu snagu.
And all you are doing is trying to do it with your mind.
I sve što pokušavate učiniti je pokušavate se oduprijeti umom.
With your human intelligence.
Sa svojom ljudskom inteligencijom.
One of the greatest industries of this civilization,
jedna od najvećih industrija ove civilizacije,
is therapies.
Su terapije.
Process, steps.
Procesi i koraci.
When I spent those many years in Hollywood, California,
kada sam proveo te mnoge godine u Hollywoodu, Kaliforniji,
I was living a pretty decadent life.
Vodio sam poprilično dekadentan život.
The alcohol, the drugs, the impure sex.
Alkohol, droga, nečisti spolni odnosi.
All of that was part of my social life.
Sve to bio dio mog društvenog života.
And many of my colleagues, actors and musicians.
I mnogi moje kolege, glumci i glazbenici.
We'll go to rehabilitation places every once or two years.
Išli bi u centar za rehabilitaciju svaki godinu ili dvije.
And we'll spend there one or two months.
I proveli bi tamo mjesec ili dva.
And pay a lot of money.
I platili puno novca.
And we'll come back out to fall back into the same vices a few months later.
I vratili se opet nazad u svijet da bi nakon nekoliko mjeseci pali u iste te poroke.
I never went to any of that.
Nikad nisam išao na ništa od toga.
And I was always wondering, why will they do that?
I uvijek sam se pitao zašto bi to činili.
But this is the way this society operates.
Ali to je način na koji ovo društvo djeluje.
It conditions people to believe.
Uvjetuje ljude da vjeruju.
That we are like that.
Da smo jednostavno takvi.
That we easily fall into addictions.
Da jednostavno upadamo u ovisnosti.
That it is simply our human nature.
Da je to jednostavno naša ljudska narav.
And that's the end of the story.
I to je kraj priče.
So you are supposed to be always looking for help.
I da bi uvijek trebali negdje vani tražiti pomoć.
To work for your addictions.
Da bi radili na svojim ovisnostima.
So it's a society that has turned into a horrible slavery to self.
To je društvo koje se pretvorilo u katastrofalno robstvo samoga sebe.
But when we really know Jesus,
ali kada zaista upoznamo Isusa,
Jesus will free us from self.
Isus će nas osloboditi od samih sebe.
Because addictions come from the worshiping of self.
Jer ovisnosti dolaze od obožavanja, klanjanja samome sebi.
Because who is addicted?
Jer tko je ovisan?
I am addicted.
Ja sam ovisan.
It's me.
To je o meni.
It's all about me.
Radi se samo o meni.
Because I am the one that is feeding the vice.
Jer ja sam taj koji hrani porok.
I am the one that is somehow attached to the vice.
Ja sam taj koji je na neki način navezan na taj porok.
So Christian science,
zato kršćanska znanost
teaches us to die to self.
Uči nas da umiremo sebi.
And when we die to self, the Holy Spirit will dwell in us.
I kada umremo sebi, Duh Sveti biti će nad nama.
Dying to self sounds like a big sentence.
Umrijeti sebi zvuči kao jedna velika rečenica.
Because you may ask yourself, how does it work?
Jer možete se pitati kako to učiniti.
And the way to die to self,
a način na koji možemo umrijeti sebi,
begins with contrition. Contrition, an act of repentance, is what you do before you confess.
A umiranje sebi započinje sa činom pokajanja.
Repentance.
Pokajanje.
When you go to confession,
kada idete na ispovjed,
and you truly approach the sacrament of confession,
i iskreno pristupite tom sakramentu,
from the bottom of your heart,
iz dubine svoga srca,
with all your mind and spirit,
sa svim svojim umom i duhom,
and you truly believe that sin is bad,
i uistinu vjerujete da je grijeh zlo,
that sin hurts you,
da nas grijeh ranjava,
that sin offends God,
da grijeh vrijeđa Boga,
that sin hurts your neighbor,
da grijeh ranjava našeg bližnjeg,
and you truly understand that,
i to istinski razumijete,
and you go and repent,
i odete i pokajete se,
and confess,
i ispovjedite.
This is the beginning of the uprooting of any vice.
To je početak iskorjenjivanja svakog poroka.
When I returned into the church after being away for 33 years,
kad sam se vratio nazad u crkvu nakon što me nije bilo 33 godine,
I began to go to confession.
Počeo sam ići na ispovjedi.
And began to understand that was my way of truly cleaning my life.
I počeo shvaćati da je to način na koji uistinu čistim svoj život.
I had many vices to let go.
Imao sam mnoge poroke koje sam trebao otpustiti.
One time I thought I was fine.
U jednom trenutku pomislio sam da sam dobro.
It was like over a year after I was back in the church.
Bilo je gotovo godinu dana nakon što sam se vratio u crkvu.
And I was standing on a corner waiting for the traffic light to change.
I stajao sam na križanju čekajući da se upali zeleno na semafor.
In Los Angeles, California.
u Los Angelesu, Kaliforniji.
For many years I was really enchanted with cars, with automobiles.
I jako dugo vremena bio sam opčinjen autima, automobilima.
I used to collect them.
Bio sam kolekcionar.
I used to raise them.
Čak sam ih iskupljao.
And I thought I was free of them.
I mislio sam da sam se oslobodio toga.
And at that moment when I was standing there waiting for a traffic light to change,
i u tom trenutku dok sam čekao da se pojavi zeleno na semaforu,
a car went by.
Auto je prošao.
And it was an extraordinary machine.
I bio je to nevjerojatan stroj.
And I looked at it.
I pogledao sam ga.
And kept on looking.
I nastavio gledati.
And kept on looking.
I dalje nastavio gledati.
And couldn't get enough of it.
I nisam ga se mogao nagledati.
And then I realized.
I tada sam shvatio.
I haven't been free from this one.
Od ovog poroka se još nisam oslobodio.
It was an amazing attachment.
To je bila nevjerojatna navezanost.
And my heart was still there.
I moje srce i dalje bilo tamo.
And it was strong.
I bilo je snažno.
Very strong.
Jako snažno.
It absolutely dominated me in that corner.
Potpuno me zaokupilo na tome križanju.
And that car was very important.
I taj auto mi je bio jako važan u tom trenutku.
So I felt really sad.
I onda sam osjetio veliku tugu.
And I knew how much I had to work.
I znao sam koliko još moram raditi.
And how little I had done.
A kako malo sam tek napravio.
Because I was thinking.
Jer sam razmišljao.
I wonder how many more vices and attachments I have.
Koliko još takvih poroka imam u sebi i navezanosti.
And it took me the rest of the year.
I cijela iduća godina mi je trebala.
To let go of that particular one.
Da bi otpustio samo tu određenu.
Because I will test myself in the streets all the time.
Jer bi se stalno na ulici preispitivao.
It was good that I was living in a very wealthy city.
I bilo je dobro zato što sam živio u jako bogatom gradu.
And I was surrounded by all this luxury.
I bio sam okružen svim tim luksuzom.
So I was able to confront it.
I mogao sam se suočiti s time.
Until I was able to let go.
Dok nisam bio u mogućnosti otpustiti.
And to feel free.
I osjećati se slobodno.
And I realized by confessing to a priest in a little town in California.
I shvatio sam ispovjedajući se kod jednog svećenika u malom gradu u Kaliforniji.
The day I was set free from that attachment.
Dan kada sam bio oslobođen te navezanosti.
The priest was a little confused.
Svećenik je bio malo zbunjen.
Because it wasn't a common confession.
Jer to nije bila običajna ispovijed.
And he was not necessarily a spiritual priest.
I nije nužno da je on bio neki duhovan svećenik.
I thought, Father, forgive me because I have worship cars.
I rekao sam, Oče, oprosti mi jer sam se klanjao autima.
And he said, excuse me.
I on mi je rekao, oprosti, šta kažeš?
How could you worship a car?
Kako se možeš klanjati autima?
So I had to give him some information about this.
Morao sam mu dati neke informacije o svemu tome.
He still thought I was being too radical and unnecessarily involved.
I dalje je mislio nakon svega toga da sam preradikalan i previše uključen.
But I told him, Father, please just give me the absolution.
Ali sam mu rekao, Oče, molim te, samo mi daj odrješenje.
If you will.
Ako želite.
And this is the steps I was taking in every aspect of my attachments and addictions.
I to su bili koraci koje sam činio u svim aspektima svojih navezanosti i ovisnosti.
Sometimes we are addicted to people.
Ponekad smo ovisni o ljudima.
Because we live in a consumed society.
jer živimo u konzumerističkom društvu.
And if we are not a spiritual people,
i ako nismo duhovni,
we become so worldly,
postajemo jako svjetovni.
That people become another piece of consumption.
Da nam osobe postanu još jedan dio našeg konzumerizma i konzumacije.
We consume friends.
Konzumiramo prijateljstva.
So we use them and then change them.
Iskoristimo ih i onda ih poslije promijenimo.
And it becomes a very strange way of worshiping people.
I to postane jedan jako čudan način klanjanja ljudima.
False idols.
Lažni idoli.
And we become very attached to people.
I postanemo jako navezani na te ljude.
In the wrong way.
Na krivi način.
Attachments that are not healthy.
Navezanosti koje nisu zdrave.
Because they become like dependencies.
Jer postanu kao nužnost u našem životu.
And then a person becomes a source of strength for me.
I ta osoba postane kao izvor snage za mene.
And then any little deception I have of that person.
I onda svaka mala nesuglasica i nerazumijevanje koje imamo toj osobi
turns into an emotional crisis.
Pretvori se u jednu emocionalnu krizu.
Because I was addicted.
Jer sam bio ovisan.
It's like the drug addict.
Kao kada narkoman ovisnik o drogi.
When the drug is not there,
kada droge nema,
then you enter a crisis.
Ulazi u krizu.
Same thing with people that is addicted to people.
Isto je tako s ljudima koji su ovisni o drugim ljudima.
If that person is not giving me what I need to receive,
ako mi ta osoba ne daje ono što ja trebam primiti,
I am not feeling good.
Ne osjećam se dobro.
I am not well.
Nisam dobro.
I gave too much power to that person.
Dao sam previše moći toj osobi.
And you notice the difference between our relationships with people.
I možete vidjeti razliku u našim odnosima s ljudima.
When we do them with the love of God.
Kada to činimo sa Božjom ljubavlju.
When we love people with the love of God,
kada volimo i ljubimo ljude Božjom ljubavlju,
is an unconditional love.
To je neuvjetovana, bezuvjetovana ljubav.
We do not depend of them.
Ne ovisimo o njima.
We love them.
Volimo ih.
And they are the people that enrich our lives.
I to su ljudi koji obogaćuju naše živote.
That complement our living,
koji komplementiraju naš cijeli život.
But that we do not depend of them.
Ali nismo ovisni o njima.
And we don't let them depend of us.
I ne dopuštamo da oni budu ovisni o nama.
Because we set them free.
Jer ih oslobađamo.
That is true love of God.
To je prava Božja ljubav.
And how do you get free from addictions?
I kako se osloboditi ovisnosti?
By making sure you are free of self.
Osiguravajući da smo se oslobodili samih sebe.
And you fill yourself with God.
I ispunili sami sebe Bogom.
You read about Saint Paul.
Čitate o Svetom Pavlu.
When one day he said,
jednog dana je rekao,
is no longer I who live, but Jesus who lives in me.
Nisam više ja koji živi, nego Krist u meni.
And Saint John the Baptist told his disciples,
a Sveti Ivan Krstitelj rekao je svojim učenicima,
I have to diminish so he can grow.
Ja treba da se umanjujem, a on treba da raste.
This is a very important teaching.
Ovo je jako bitno učenje.
Because when you learn to let God be in you,
jer kada naučimo da Bog prebiva u nama,
you do not have any existential crisis.
Onda više ne postoje egzistencijalne krize.
You do not have any voids of affection.
Nema više nekakvih praznina ili navezanosti.
You don't have any loneliness.
Nema više usamljenosti.
You don't have any insecurities and anguish.
Nema nekih nesigurnosti i tjeskoba.
which are the sources of addictions.
Koji su sve uzroci ovisnosti.
Addictions come from loneliness.
Ovisnosti dolaze iz usamljenosti.
From anguish.
Tjeskobe.
From self-destructive tendencies.
Od samodestruktivnih želja.
Created by voids of affection.
Stvorenih od praznina
which
i navezanosti.
Are, which are dependencies of human affection.
Koje su ovisne o ljudskim stvarima, o ljudskim potrebama.
And they call them many ways.
I zovu ih na mnoge načine.
Wounds.
Rane.
Wound is a very popular word.
Rana je jako popularna riječ.
Modern psychology uses wounds left and right.
Moderna psihologija na sve strane koristi tu riječ.
I heard of a woman that was close to 100 years old.
Čuo sam za jednu ženu koja je imala skoro 100 godina.
She was a German woman.
Bila je Njemica.
She during the Holocaust of the Nazis.
Tijekom holokausta od strane nacista.
She was a Catholic.
Bila je katolkinja.
She was trying to escape from Germany into Holland.
Pokušala je pobjeći iz Njemačke u Nizozemsku.
But she was caught by the Nazis at the border.
Ali uhvatili su je nacisti na granici.
And they put her in a cell.
I stavili su u jednu čeliju.
And many soldiers raped her for 2-3 days.
I tijekom 2 ili 3 dana mnogi vojnici su je silovali.
And when they thought she was dead, they threw her into Holland.
I kada su mislili da je već umrla, bacili su na drugu stranu Nizozemsku.
But she survived.
Ali ona je preživjela.
So many years later I found out about her.
Mnogo godina nakon saznao sam za nju.
And this woman looked like an angel.
A ta žena izgledala je kao anđeo.
Her face was as bright as the sun.
Njeno lice sjalo je kao sunce.
And she was testifying.
I svjedočila je.
I don't have any wounds.
Nemam nikakvih rana.
Jesus has given me back my virginity.
Isus mi je vratio moje djevičanstvo.
I am a virgin of Christ.
Ja sam Kristova djevica.
And she was given this incredible simple teaching.
I dala nam je to jako jednostavno svjedočanstvo i pouku.
About being free with the love of God.
O tome kako biti slobodan po ljubavi Božjoj.
And how to let go of every wound of your past.
I kako otpustiti svaku ranu naše prošlosti.
How to overcome every one of them.
Kako prijeći preko svake od njih.
How not to be stuck in your past.
Kako ne biti zarobljen u prošlosti.
How not to be whining about what hurt you in the past.
Kako ne biti cijelo vrijeme u nekom samosažaljevanju zbog stvari koje su se dogodile.
Regardless of how horrible it could have been.
Bez obzira koliko strašne one mogle biti.
The love of God.
Ljubav Božja.
Makes us new time and time again.
Čini nas potpuno novima iznova iznova svaki puta.
The power of the sacraments.
Snaga sakramenata.
Confession, the Eucharist.
Ispovjedi, Euharistija.
The power of prayer.
Moć molitve, snaga molitve.
Are the most amazing forces of healing.
Su najjače sile liječenja, isceljenja.
The most amazing forces of deliverance.
Najveća snaga je u njima u oslobađanju.
And we have this treasure in the church.
I to blago imamo u crkvi.
So if we really are Catholics.
Ako smo uistinu katolici.
True faith.
Po vjeri.
We can be free from any addiction.
Možemo biti oslobođeni bilo kakve ovisnosti.
It's absolutely possible.
To je apsolutno moguće.
We have a great example of that.
Imamo jedan prekrasan primjer toga.
In Međugorje.
U Međugorju.
Through the Cenacolos, I'm sure you heard about.
Po zajednici Cenacolos, za koju vjerujem da ste čuli.
People are healed from very difficult addictions through prayer.
Ljudi su po molitvi izliječeni od raznih ovisnosti, teških ovisnosti.
Through an spiritual life.
Po duhovnom životu.
No medications, no therapies.
Bez liječenja, bez terapija.
The love of God.
Božja ljubav.
And it's proven that it works faster, better and more permanent than any other treatment.
I dokazano je da radi, da djeluje brže, bolje i dugotrajnije od bilo kakve terapije i tretmana.
Because once you embrace the true love of God,
jer kada jednom prihvatimo pravu ljubav Božju,
you begin a true healing.
Počinjemo istinsko iscjeljenje, izlječenje.
And yes, you have to persevere.
I da, treba ustrajati.
I was kidnapped by guerrillas in Colombia.
Bio sam otet od gerilaca u Kolumbiji.
And kept in the jungle for 6 months.
I 6 mjeseci su me držali u džungli.
I can never tell you the tortures I went through.
Nikad vam ne bi mogao opisati sva mučenja koja sam prošao.
Physical and psychologically.
I fizička i psihološka.
During that time is when Jesus appeared to me.
Tijekom tog vremena mi se objavio Isus.
And even though Jesus appeared to me,
iako mi se Isus ukazao,
when I came out of the jungle miraculously,
kada sam čudesno izašao iz te džungle
and begin my new life,
i započeo svoj novi život,
I was carrying with me all the wounds of the kidnapping.
Sa sobom sam nosio sve te rane koje sam dobio za vrijeme zatočeništva.
All the tortures.
Sva mučenja.
The hatred from those people.
Mržnju od tih ljudi.
And the horror of 6 months of hell.
I horor tih 6 mjeseci pakla.
And I went with Jesus with that.
I sa kroz to sam prolazio s Isusom.
I never took a therapy.
Nikad nisam išao na terapiju.
I went into God.
Otišao sam k Bogu.
It took me 2 or 3 years.
Trebalo mi je 2 ili 3 godine.
To completely clean up from that pain.
Da bi se potpuno očistio od te boli.
From those memories.
Od tih sjećanja.
From that hatred.
Od te mržnje.
From the feelings of revenge.
Od želje i osjećaja za osvetom.
These people stole from me the money I had worked for 30 years.
Ti ljudi su mi ukrali novac za koji sam radio 33 godine.
And that was also a very difficult thing to deal with.
I to je bila jako teška stvar za suočiti se.
Because I was very addicted to money.
Jer sam bio jako navezan, jako ovisan o novcu.
And to let go of the money.
I otpustiti sav taj novac.
And to accept that these criminals had it and they were just using it.
I prihvatiti da su taj novac sad imali kriminalci koji su ga koristili kako su htjeli.
That was an amazing torture for me for a long time.
To je dugo vremena predstavljalo veliko mučenje za mene.
But every time that came to my heart,
ali svaki put kada bi mi to došlo na srce,
I will go on my knees.
Pao bih na koljena.
And I will go to confession.
I otišao na ispovijed.
And I will take the Eucharist.
I primio bih Eukaristiju.
And I will pray the rosary.
Molio bih krunicu.
And I will beg God.
I molio bih Boga.
And little by little, little by little I came out.
I malo pomalo izašao sam iz toga.
And one day I was given a testimony in Holland.
I jednog dana imao sam svjedočanstvo u Nizozemskoj.
And when I finished there were questions.
I kada sam završio bilo je pitanje.
And a lady asked me.
I jedna gospođa me pitala.
Did you forgive your captors?
Jesi li oprostio svojim otmičarima?
And I realized I already had done it.
I shvatio sam, već sam to učinio.
But I didn't know it.
Ali nisam znao to.
Because I ended up forgiving and forgetting.
Jer prestao sam opraštati i zaboravljati.
But I didn't notice it.
Ali nisam to primijetio.
So that was like the Holy Spirit talking to me through that woman.
To je kao da mi je Duh Sveti progovorio po toj ženi.
And I could see that it was God that was telling me, you are free.
I kao da mi je Bog htio reći i proučiti mi, sada si slobodan.
And it was an amazing feeling.
I to je bio nevjerojatan osjećaj.
Because I felt the freedom.
Jer sam osjetio tu slobodu.
And I didn't realize I had been free for a while.
I neko vrijeme uopće nisam shvatio da sam slobodan.
But this is the way the Holy Spirit works in our lives.
Ali to je način na koji Duh Sveti radi u našim životima.
If we persevere.
Ako ustrajemo.
If we go on day after day.
Ako dan za danom ponovno idemo.
Fighting against what is wrong in our lives.
Boreći se protiv onoga što je loše u našim životima.
With prayer, with the sacraments.
S molitvom, sakramentima.
With Jesus.
S Isusom.
He will take us out.
On će nas izbaviti.
He will free us.
On će nas osloboditi.
I am a witness.
Ja sam svjedok.
I have done it.
Ja sam to učinio.
Or better to say, God has done it for me.
Ili još bolje rečeno, Bog je to učinio za mene.
But I had opened my heart to God so that he can do it.
Ali ja sam otvorio svoje srce Bogu da on to može učiniti.
And this is the freedom of addictions.
I to je sloboda od ovisnosti.
Christ.
Krist.
He is our savior.
On je naš spasitelj.
He is our freedom.
On je naša sloboda.
And it sounds easy.
I zvuči lagano.
But we have to remember.
Ali moramo se sjetiti.
We have to walk the walk of our freedom.
Ali moramo hodati stazom naše slobode.
We have to be patient.
Moramo biti strpljivi.
Persevering.
Ustrajni.
Compassionate.
Suosjećajni.
Charitable.
Milosrdni, darežljivi.
With self and with life.
I sa sobom i sa životom.
And with God.
I s Bogom.
Because doubts will come along.
Jer usput će doći sumnje.
Sometimes you feel you're never gonna make it.
Nekad će vam se činiti kao da nikad nećete doći do toga.
But if you go on, if you go on.
Ali ako ustrajete.
You will make it.
Uspjet ćete.
And you'll be much stronger.
I bit ćete mnogo snažniji.
See, one of the greatest handicaps of people today in this society.
Vidite, jedan od najvećih hendikepa ljudi u današnjem društvu
is impure sexuality.
Je nečista seksualnost, spolnost.
Many addictions to sex.
Mnogi su ovisni o seksu.
It comes through pornography.
Dolazi po pornografiji.
Which leads to masturbation.
Koja vodi u samozadovoljavanje.
And masturbation kills life.
A samozadovoljavanje ubija život.
And masturbation is a homosexual act.
I samozadovoljavanje je homoseksualni čin.
Because you are having sex with the same sex.
Jer imate spolni odnos sa istim spolom, sa samim sobom.
And that depletes you.
I to vas uništava.
Makes you weak.
Čini vas slabima.
Because you are throwing life away.
Jer bacate život. Odbacujete ga.
You are killing.
Ubijate.
And this makes people really weak mentally.
I to ljude čini mentalno jako slabima.
Emotionally.
Emocionalno.
Spiritually guilty.
Duhovno, osjećaju duhovnu krivicu.
It destroys your integrity.
Uništava vaš integritet.
And it is one of the reasons why so many couples have problems today.
I to je jedan od razloga zašto mnogi parovi imaju problema danas.
Because when they make it into marriage,
jer kada uđu u brak,
their sexuality is damaged.
Njihova seksualnost je već ranjena.
And very few can put it together.
I rijetki su oni koji to mogu ponovno sastaviti.
So that's why today is so important to be vigilant.
Zato je danas toliko bitno biti budan, obazriv.
Because we live in a sexualized culture.
Jer živimo u seksualiziranoj kulturi.
And you know, to speak about sex from the pulpit.
I znate, pričati o seksualnosti s oltara.
Is a taboo.
Je tabu.
You're not supposed to talk about sex from here in the church.
O tome se ne bi trebalo pričati odavde u crkvi.
But everybody talks about it in the car, in the bar.
Ali svi o tome slobodno pričaju u autu, u kafiću.
Among friends everywhere.
Među prijateljima bilo gdje drugdje.
But don't mention it from the pulpit.
Ali slučajno nemoj to spominjati s ambona.
Everybody will be scandalized.
Svi će biti sablažnjeni.
It's a hypocritical type of culture in that sense.
To je licemjerna kultura u tom pogledu.
But is the devil.
Ali to je u stvari đavo.
That's how Satan works.
Tako Sotona djeluje.
So astute.
Jako lukavo.
We cannot let him.
Ne smijemo mu to dozvoliti.
We have to unmask evil.
Moramo razotkriti zlo.
And we have to confront it.
I moramo mu se suprotstaviti.
And speak about it.
I pričati o tome.
Because you know one of the greatest ways of exorcising demons.
Jer znate da je jedan od najboljih načina egzorciziranja demona
is to unmask them.
Je razotkriti ih.
If you exhibit them,
ako ih razotkrijemo,
they run.
Oni bježe.
Because they live in the dark.
Jer oni žive u tami.
So if they are acknowledged,
i ako su prepoznati,
if you say, here they are,
i ako kažeš, evo ih ovdje,
they run.
Pobjeće.
Because they are like thieves.
Jer oni su poput lopova.
Stealing in the darkness.
Kradu u tami.
So put the light on and they will be gone.
Uključite svjetlo i pobjeći će.
And the way to put the light on,
i način kako upaliti svjetlo
is to face it,
je suprotstaviti im se.
To understand what your problem is.
Shvatiti koji su vaši problemi.
You have a problem with your sexuality.
Imate problem sa svojom spolnošću, seksualnosti.
Face it.
Suočite se.
Admit it.
Priznajte.
Stop it.
I prestanite.
If there is anything good you can do in your life,
ako postoji jedna stvar koju možete napraviti, a da je dobra,
is to stop impure sexuality.
Je prestati sa nečistom seksualnosti.
It damages you.
Šteti vama.
It hurts you
badly. Vas ranjava jako.
Because it takes away the integrity of life.
Jer oduzima integritet života.
It makes you a weak human being.
Čini vas slabom ljudskom osobom.
And we need to be strong.
A moramo biti jaki.
We live in a very difficult world.
Živimo u jako teškom svijetu.
Very dark.
Jako tamnom.
So we cannot afford to waste our energy.
I ne smijemo dopustiti da bacamo bez veze svoju snagu i energiju.
To waste our integrity.
Potratiti naš integritet.
So we know that God is asking us tonight something very important.
I znamo da nas Gospodin večeras traži jednu jako bitnu stvar.
If we do believe in Jesus Christ as our God,
ako vjerujemo u Isusa Krista kao našega Gospodina i Boga,
then we have to understand,
onda moramo shvatiti,
that Jesus is the power.
Da je Isus snaga.
The mighty power.
Moćna snaga.
The one that can change and transform everything.
Onaj koji može sve promijeniti i sve transformirati.
I am able to testify to that with my own life.
Ja mogu svojim životom to posvjedočiti.
Jesus has absolutely transformed me.
Isus me u potpunosti preobrazio i transformirao.
If you could understand who I was 25 years ago,
kada bi mogli shvatiti tko sam bio prije 25 godina,
you would be incredibly surprised.
Bili biste nevjerojatno iznenađeni.
I was the most worldly person you can ever imagine.
Bio sam najsvjetovnija osoba koju možete zamisliti.
I worshiped so many false gods.
Klanjao sam se tolikim lažnim bogovima.
And I was a plain earthly human being.
I bio sam potpuno svjetovan čovjek.
No sense of spirit.
Bez ikakvog smisla za duhovno.
Only sense of the dark because of the magic and the new age.
Samo sa osjećajem za ono što je mračno jer sam bio u new age-u i magiji.
Which I thought it was the greatest thing.
Što sam mislio da je najbolja stvar na svijetu.
So today I am a new human being.
Danas sam potpuno novo ljudsko biće.
I am not pretending to be a saint.
Ne pravim se da sam svetac.
But I want to be one.
ali želim biti jedan.
And every day I try to work towards that.
I svaki dan pokušavam raditi da idem prema tome.
And it's tough.
I teško je.
Because you have to walk up every day to convert.
Jer morate se svako jutro probuditi i obratiti se.
Every day is new.
Svaki dan je novi dan.
A new battle.
Nova bitka.
New temptations.
Nove napasti.
And you have to be vigilant.
I morate biti budni.
To make sure you convert every day.
Da ste sigurni da ste se svaki dan obratili.
But it is beautiful and powerful.
Ali je prekrasno i snažno.
To live a life.
Živjeti život.
Of permanent conversion.
Trajnog obraćenja.
Because that gives you a sense of life in God.
Jer to vam daje osjećaj kako je živjeti u Bogu.
So your heart is filled with hope.
Vaše srce je ispunjeno nadom.
Is filled with peace.
Ispunjeno mirom.
And you have a joy.
I imate radost.
That the world can never give you.
Koju vam svijet nikad ne može dati.
I had many things in this world when I was an artist.
Imao sam mnoge stvari na ovom svijetu kad sam bio umjetnik.
Lots of money, fame.
Puno auta, slavu.
I could do whatever I wanted.
Mogao sam činiti sve što sam htio.
But I never had the joy and the peace that I have today.
Ali nikad nisam imao mir i radost koju imam danas.
And I don't have any of the wounds that I had then.
I nemam ni jednu od rana koju sam tada imao.
Because I have found the real treasure.
Jer sam pronašao istinsko blago.
Or better to say, the real treasure found me.
Ili još bolje rečeno, istinsko blago je pronašlo mene.
And rescue me.
I spasilo me.
Jesus.
Isus.
And I always tell people.
I uvijek kažem ljudima.
Make sure.
Osigurajte.
That the name of Jesus.
Da je ime Isus.
Is your life.
Je vaš život.
Always say Jesus.
Uvijek govorite Isus.
And you never be alone.
I nikad nećete biti sami.
You never be addicted.
Nikad nećete biti ovisni.
You never depend on anything.
Nećete biti oslonjeni ni ovisni na ništa drugo.
Or anybody.
Ili nekog drugog.
Because you have the true God with you.
Jer imate pravog Boga u sebe.
So praise Jesus.
Zato slavite Isusa, hvalite Isusa.
Amen.
Amen.